opened in 1943, it was used by both the Royal Air Force and the United States Army Air Force. Basically complete late in 1943 and opened on New Year's Day 1944, the station had already been earmarked for US troop carrier use. The station complement squadron moved in to ready the base between the 4th and the 7th of January. On the 7th of January 1944, the 315th Troop Carrier Group took up residence in somewhat reduced organisation, as most had been sent to North Africa during May 1943. In 1946, RAF Spanhoe was closed and returned to the farmers from whom it had been requisitioned. On the 12th of August 1960, Vickers Valiant of No. 7 Squadron Nose Wheel failed to retract and take off from RAF Wittering. While sorting it out, the aircraft stalled and crashed into the ground at Spanhoe Airfield. All five of the crew were killed. During the war, it was used primarily as a transport airfield, and after the war, it was closed in late 1945. Today, much of the airfield has been returned to agriculture. However, one runway remains on the airfield, currently active, and houses various privately owned light aircraft.
To the mung jack?
Yeah.
Mel.
Head that way.
Say nothing because you're at the entrance.
Hi everyone, just heading up to the mess site number 2. There's nothing left and it's been returned back to farmland, and all that remains is the concrete track and a blast shelter that's not marked on the site plans. What would have been there is the officers' mess, commissioned officers' quarters, officers' showers block, sergeant's mess, sergeant's shower block, a water tank, airman's shower, ablutions and the contaminant room, WAFs, ablutions and latrine block, airman's latrines, fuel compound, dining room and a picket post.
Splash shower.
heading up to the communal site number 4 now, which would have had the institute with the WAF room, grocery and local produce store, ration store, tailors, barbers and shoemaker's shop, airmen's latrines, educational block, gymnasium, squash court, fuel compound again, a standby set house, chlorination plant house, picket post and a water tower. This is the area of the mess site number 3, which would have had the officers' mess, officers' shower block, sergeant's mess, sergeant's shower block, the water tank, airmen's showers, ablutions, airmen's latrines, fuel compound, a dining room, a latrine, bucket emptying and cleaning plant room, and the picket post. Just walking to where the dining room would have been. All that's remaining is a window, and nature is taking it back as the trees growing out of it. beyond the hedgerow line would have branched off left and right to the sick quarters and site number 7, but now sadly returned back to agricultural fields. Approaching the WAF site number 10, this would have had the officers' quarters and baths, a women's baths and decontamination building, fuel compound, sergeant's quarters, airwoman's, barrack huts and a guardhouse.
fence base rather than.
This is a water tower that's not shown on the site drawings. Also, later on, there is several air raid shelters that's not marked on the plans either.
Yeah.
didn't go any further as it backed onto someone's property, but it was one of the entrances down to the dispersed sites and the WAF communal and quarters site number 10.